What does it take to capture a beautiful looking screenshot? Well, it takes a lot, but it's not as hard as you may think. In this video, I'm going to explain the basics and share my own experience in taking screenshots in video games, and hopefully this is going to motivate more people to start doing this. Just a little background, I'm not considering myself as some kind of professional in this, I'm just an enthusiast who's taken screenshots for approximately 10 years. I was getting a lot of positive feedback about my works, and some of my friends asked me what exactly I'm doing to achieve such results, so I've decided to share the tricks I learned and show that I'm not doing any kind of sorcery to be good at this. I'm not even doing any post-capture editing, except image flip for my vertical shots, so being proficient in photo and graphics editors is completely optional. Okay, let's get started. So what's the first thing that you need to do when you want to take a screenshot? Obviously, you need to have a tool to make this capture. For example, you can use Windows built-in tools like Print Screen. Fine, maybe that's not the best idea, but it's still an option that people might consider if they for some reason can't use anything else. I mean, that's how I actually started taking screenshots back then. I was playing the game, saw some cool looking place, pressed print screen, minimized the game, open paint, paste from buffer, and save the image file. At least now you can skip all those steps and just press Windows logo and print screen keys together, and your capture will appear as PNG file in default folder. Personally, I don't use this feature, but from what I've seen, the quality of captures looks good enough, and if you really can't use anything else, then it will be a good starting point. The other option is to use third-party tools for your captures. At first I was using Fraps, but it's even less relevant now than Print Screen Button. These days there are tons of free software that has screenshot feature.
For example, MSI Afterburner or Reshade. But be careful, some of those programs can be falsely detected as cheats in several online games like PUBG. To be 100% safe, you can use proprietary overlays from Nvidia and or AMD. And also, every relevant games launcher like Steam and Uplay can take screenshots as well.
Personally, I'm using Steam for most of my captures because it's pretty straightforward to use, and this is where the most of my games library. I know there's a lot of horror stories about how bad Steam for taking screenshots, and I can confirm that few years ago it was really not the best option for that. But since then, Valve improved this feature significantly. From my observations, Steam JPEGs files are compared to output that you can get after converting the PNG file to JPEG format with 95% quality, which is a pretty good result. Yes, it's not perfect, but most people won't be able to tell the difference between lossless and distally compressed screenshots. And if you're still determined on getting the best possible image quality, then Steam also allows saving an uncompressed copy of your screenshots. Though there is still one flaw with Steam, it completely ignores every other overlays. So if you are going to add some filters with, for example, Nvidia Unself Photo Mode, Steam will completely ignore them. If you are going to take a screenshot with Unself while also keeping Steam overlay on, it will capture Steam notifications, so remember to disable them before taking the pictures, or you'll end up with frame rate counters and screenshots saved all over your screenshots. But other than that, proprietary software from Nvidia and AMD is your next best option after Steam. They are capturing uncompressed screenshots and have some cool features that can help you to enhance image quality. Unfortunately, while GeForce Experience and Radeon Relive are not tied to launchers, you won't be able to use them unless you have the right GPU. So choose your tools depending on the hardware and your own preferences in terms of image quality. Okay, the second thing that you need to learn is how to remove HUD from the games. HUD means heads up display, and this is basically all the elements of the interfaces that you can see in games, like menus, minimaps, crosshair, and so on. While most of the games become unplayable without HUD, finding the way to disable it, at least temporarily, should be your first priority. Some of the games have built-in options or photo modes or at least NVIDIA Ansel support, but in most cases you have to use custom tools and cheats. Again, while those tools are very helpful, they are not safe to use in online games, so be careful or you can get banned for using them. There are different solutions for each game, so I won't cover them in this video, but in order to find them you need to use those search queries: game title with added remove HUD or disable UI or free camera. You should also check sites like Framed or No HUD Wiki. They are great sources to find the right camera tools, so be sure to check them out. Another thing that you need to think about is the resolution of your screenshots. Well, it's okay to aim for higher frame rates rather than higher resolution when you're playing your games. You need to consider switching to 4K, at least temporarily, before you take in your shot. To illustrate why resolution is important, I'm going to show you one of my old screenshots that I took in 2009 and how it looks like now on 4K resolution display. Yeah, who would have thought back then that there will be monitors with resolution higher than 720p that won't cost a fortune. But seriously, think about how your awesome screenshot will look a few years later on modern displays. Right now, 4K is the optimal choice that you can realistically achieve on the modern hardware in recent graphics-heavy games, but if you can go higher, then go for it. Now that's where lies the main problem of higher resolutions. They require tons of horsepower, especially if you're going to play with highest available graphical presets. All those high quality textures and effects requires very powerful hardware to render them in real time, and not many people are ready to spend a fortune to get prettier pictures. And even if you're lucky enough to have the powerful hardware that's available now on the market, in some recent games you still won't be able to achieve stable 60 frames per second at 4K resolution with everything pumped to the max. So yeah, prepare to spend a lot of time in settings menu trying to achieve the right balance between performance and image quality. While it all sounds pretty bad, that doesn't mean that you actually need to spend all those thousands of dollars in order to get a better looking pictures. First of all, you don't need to have a 4K display in order to capture a 4K screenshot. You can get it even on 1080p display. There are two ways in doing this: super sampling and hot sampling. Super sampling allows you to render games in resolutions higher than your native resolution, and you can enable it via dynamic super resolution if you have NVIDIA GPU, or virtual super resolution if you prefer AMD products. Once you enable those settings through the control panel of your graphics card, you can enable super sampling resolution in game settings, but in most cases it works only in exclusive full screen. On the other hand, hot sampling not tied to hardware and works in windowed mode, but it requires using third-party tools like Simple Runtime Window Editor, and they might not work with every game. In conclusion to technical stuff, I just want to say that while better graphics and higher resolutions are important, that doesn't mean that you need to give up on the idea just because you don't have a powerful hardware. It's all optional, especially for starters. 8K resolution won't magically turn a bad image into a good one. It only can make a great screenshot even better. Most people are still using 1080p monitors anyway, and it'll take a few more years for 4K to finally become a mainstream. In the meantime, you can get the tools I mentioned and start practicing. So maybe I'm going to say an obvious thing right now, but taking screenshots in games mostly follows the same rules as photography in real life. Hence why most people use the term virtual photography to describe the process of taking screenshots in video games. Stuff like composition, field of view, lighting, colors, angles, most of this stuff is no different in professional photography. For example, the most common way to achieve the right composition in the frame is to use a rule of thirds. You need to mentally divide screen space into 9 equal parts by 2 equally spaced horizontal lines and 2 equally spaced vertical lines. By following this guideline, you need to place important objects on your scene along these lines and or their intersections. To make things easier for you, some photo modes provide the ability to show those lines, but once you practice enough, you'll be able to quickly imagine this grid without helpers. Same with everything else. Look for interesting viewpoints, always pay attention for the details in the background, look for in places with good lighting, and keep an eye on the frame. Don't cut off body parts with it. Find the right field of view depending on the scene you want to capture. Low field of view is great when you want to highlight the details, and high field of view are used to show scale. Everything in moderation. If you see an interesting pattern or symmetry, then adjust the camera point and fill the frame right. If you think colors are not good enough, then use filters, but don't overdo with them and find the right balance to keep it looking natural. Most importantly, you need to practice a lot. Don't expect to take something breathtaking after a few tries. You need to look critically at your works and notice every flaw and small detail. And you need to remember where did you did those mistakes in order to not repeat them again in the future. To have more room for mistakes like that, take several shots from the same scene you want to capture. Try different angles and filters and then choose the best version after you're done. Picking up the best shot out of the series of slightly different screenshots is a huge pain in the ass, but it's worth it, believe me. For easier sorting, and you can use software like Fast Stone Image Viewer that allows you to compare up to 4 images side by side and see other input info like color histograms that will help you to determine which one of your screenshots is the best. Another thing that you need to realize is the fact that the process of taking screenshots can be really time consuming. For example, I played Shadow of the Tomb Raider for 100 hours and almost half of this time I spent in photo mode, so looking for good places to take a screenshot. It can easily take from 5 to 30 minutes to capture a single scene, while trying different angles and settings or building and adjusting the scenery by moving objects and characters in the right places. All this requires a lot of dedication and patience, because you can easily waste all this time and got nothing worthwhile in the end. Not to mention that such long pauses can negatively affect the actual gameplay pacing in story-driven games. And finally, taking a good-looking screenshot is heavily depending on the luck, especially if you're trying to capture something dynamic. Action shots are really cool, but it's really challenging to catch the right moment, and it's usually when all the game engine flaws become really noticeable. It usually happens unexpectedly, and you need to act fast, like on this Assassin's Creed Odyssey clip that you see right now, where I was playing as usual and suddenly noticed deer in the water and thought, hey, it might look good. And I entered photo mode right at the second when he started moving. After fiddling with photo mode for a few minutes, I tried to instantly re-enter photo mode to get another capture, but deer was too fast and left the scene already. Just 1 second and such a huge difference. I highly doubt I could have recreated the screenshot even if I was prepared. In order to increase your chances in capturing a cool-looking action shots, I highly recommend you to get the mouse with extra buttons and have a dedicated button to enter a photo mode or time freeze. There are tons of these mouses on the market. Right now I'm using Logitech G102 And it even allows to assign shortcuts if entering photo mode requires to press more than one button. Even if you don't have a mouse with extra buttons, you can always create your own keyboard shortcuts with software like Auto Hotkey and remap photo mode functions for higher convenience. Few last things that might be worth mentioning. First, try to avoid taking screenshots from cutscenes.
Unless you free up the camera and taking them from different point of view. I admit that I occasionally taking them as well, but think about it. There is no challenge in screen caping already prepared scenes, and most importantly, do you really think you'll be the only one who took a screenshot in this cool looking moment in this cutscene that everyone saw? Get used to the fact that you may see things differently than others, and people won't get as excited about your new work as you expected. I can't tell how many times the screenshot that in my eyes was something absolutely amazing ended up not creating any spark and passed almost unnoticed. It works the other way around. Some captures that I had no faith and shared only because I got nothing better at the moment suddenly were getting completely unexpected attention and praise. So yeah, be critical, but don't worry about it too much and just always try to do your best. Find friends and communities who share in your interests and love taking screenshots as much as you do. It's important in order to improve yourself by looking at screenshots that were taken by other people and getting feedback about your own work. Don't turn this hobby into a full-time job, unless you actually get paid for it, of course. Don't forget to occasionally simply enjoy playing game. You are basically doing free marketing for those companies while spending your own money and time on the game, so don't let yourself carried away and allow it to affect your enjoyment. Not every screenshot is supposed to be beautiful.
Alright, I think I covered most of the basics in this field. Hope I didn't forget anything. Well, even if I forgot something, feel free to ask in comments and I'll try to answer you as soon as possible. Or make another video if your question will deserve a more detailed response. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and be sure to check out my Patreon page and other useful links that I left in the description to this video. Good luck in screen archery, and I'm looking forward to see your screenshots.